Today is the 19th of March, and we're undergoing some really big changes in the world. We're being threatened by the coronavirus, and it's really made the world a lot different. In any case, there's been a run on hand sanitizer and face masks. There's just not enough to, satisfy the world's need for them. And I thought I would just give you some tips that I came up with to make your own with anything around the house. And, you could use your imagination because I'm going to give you a few ideas I came up with. One of them was having a face mask. If you have a blindfold or a sleeping mask, you could turn this, of course, into a face mask very easily, simple. That was easy. Okay. If you have any kind of push-up bra or sport bra, you can see here it's got a very good shape, and boom, you have a pretty much ready-to-wear mask with a few adjustments, a few minor adjustments. Underwear can also provide you with the similar. I had a pair of compression socks that I had worked on somewhere around here, which can turn into a mask very simply by stuffing them. They have an opening at each end, so you put a paper towel rolled up and folded inside the sock to give it some kind of form and shape and sturdiness. This goes around your face, of course, like that, and a little heel goes for, makes the sock look like a mask. And then, if you've seen my other video, 1001 Things You Could Do with a Pair of Stockings, this is from a pair of tights. And what you do is you just cut them in little loops, like rubber band loops. Cut them open and attach them with a quick sew. You can sew a few stitches, I'm sure, into the sock on each end. And voila, you'll have a face mask, okay? Now, I also have another pair of leggings I'm going to turn into lots of things. I'll turn this into rubber bands. I'll turn this into a headband. These are just leggings that maybe aren't that stylish or don't fit me anymore or whatever, they've lost their appeal. But they're a cool print. I could make this, of course, into a face mask by cutting it also in a loop. And also, you can use a face mask as a template or as a pattern. Like this. If you have an old face mask or a new face mask, in any case, you can use this as a template by putting it down onto the fabric and cutting around it. You'll just trace a shape, of the face mask, cut around the fabric, which I plan to do. And then you could make your own in the shape of an actual face mask with even the bends if you do it correctly and stretch out the fabric. So there you have it. I hope it's been, I hope my advice has helped some people that feel like they don't have access to any face masks. You've got plenty of access because everything in your house can turn into something else. Okay. Good luck and stay healthy. Bye.